Why don't we do this more often?
Why don't we?
Just what we're doing.
Hi, I'm Don Barry, and this is 3 minutes without Mike, kind of an extended version today. I want to share with you a little history. Many of you may not know it, but Chester FBC just passed a pretty big milestone. 84 years as a congregation in the city of Chester, Illinois.
Why don't we do this more often? Just what we're doing.
It actually started right here, or very close to here, behind what was then the old courthouse. The old courthouse had a huge grassy yard behind it with a bandstand. Well, a group of preachers from DuCoin, Pinckneyville, and Ellis Grove held revival meetings here in July of 1936. Sadly, the Spirit of God did not move, or perhaps Chester didn't respond. But this didn't stop those men of God or their churches from praying about the city of Chester.
Gee, but it's great to get together again. Why does it only happen now?
A year went by, and those other churches prayed for our community. Ellis Grove led the way, and they came here. We're just about a half a block away from where we worship at today. This is the site of Chester's old grade school, and it was here that those godly folks from out of town put up a big tent revival. The revival went on for 5 solid weeks. Now think about that. July 1937. You know how it is today and in the past few weeks? But prayers were answered and people were saved. Several people who lived in Chester but were attending at Ellis Grove then moved their membership. And the Missionary Baptist Church of Chester, Illinois was started with 33 charter members.
Just what we're doing tonight.
This early congregation met in each other's homes, and over there at the Opera House, they had meetings there until finally they purchased land near the library where the church building today now stands.
You can never, ever overdo a good thing. So honey, why don't this morning...
The young church called their first pastor. His name was Floyd Roth. And in 1939, 2 years after the church actually was incorporated, they built a parsonage for their new pastor. And it stood right here where we're at. And now it's been replaced by an education building back in 1973. But those men of the day had a big task of digging out the foundation for our church building. They did it by hand, using just picks and shovels. They would come in after work, and young boys would come in after school, and they would dig until dark. And sometimes their work became vandalized because there were folks who just didn't really want a Baptist church right here in Chester. Through their hard work and lots of prayer, they had their basement church by 1940. Now, we recently remodeled this area, and we found those old walls and the floor are still solid. Good concrete in those days. No cracks were found anywhere. The door was right here, and there would have been a sharp flight of stairs coming down. And this would have taken you into the Missionary Baptist Church of Chester, Illinois. Now the congregation grew, and it was interrupted by a big thing called World War II.
He had a bookish style that no one else could play. He was the top man at his craft.
But by the late 1940s, they knew they had to grow even more.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 10, 11 o'clock.
They decided to go up, and they undertook the project of finishing the building with an upstairs sanctuary. And in 1950, it was finished. One of my favorite stories concerns these beautiful stained glass windows. Now, if you've ever sat here and noticed, each one of them have a little panel showing who donated the funds for these windows to be purchased. Now, as I understand, in 1950, they would have cost around $1,000 to $1,200 each. Now, take into consideration in those days that the average wage earner, probably in Chester, made maybe $100 to $125 a month. So people were donating, groups, business people from town, people who weren't even part of the church. Well, there was a family in this church named Charles and Ella Bullock. They had several children. They were both very involved in the church. Mr. Bullock was a Sunday school teacher, a trustee. His wife was in charge of Sunday school as a director. She was a Sunday school teacher. Just good people. The pastor put out a plea. We need more money. We don't have enough money to put all the stained glass windows in. So on a Sunday afternoon, following a church service, Charles went home with his family. Ella had a beautiful lunch ready. And as the family prayed over their food, afterwards he said amen, and he said, "Family, tomorrow morning I'm going to the bank and I'm going to remortgage your house because we're going to buy a stained glass window for our church." I'm reminded of scripture from Hebrews 11, 1 through 3 as I tell you these stories. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good testimony. By faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which were visible. There are so many other great stories and great examples of faith and devotion of the people who made it possible for us to be here today. A whole 84 years worth of stories. But you know, the beautiful thing about history is that it's still being made today. And you can be a part of that. Come be with us at Chester FBC. There are a lot of different ways for you to serve here. And join us this Saturday evening as we celebrate the anniversary, 84 years, out at Cole Park. Starting at 5 p.m., we're going to have some worship, some food, some fun. Come and join us. And then Sunday morning at 10:30, come right back, come here, and worship with us. Hope to see you soon. Thanks for watching.